Hermanos. Do I know who's in it? Not really. I know it's a movie from either Colombia or Argentina. And what is it about? Well, by the poster. I really saw this movie by the poster because today I was supposed to see this and Lucy in the Sky. But then my mom called and the phone call lasted a long time, so I didn't see Lucy in the Sky. So it was just Monos for now. You see, it's dark. I'm going to see two other movies tonight. I'm going back to back, yo, tonight. But anyway, Monos, what is it about? Well, it follows this kind of organization of these teens or young adults who are watching a prisoner who is an American doctor, like I said, in Colombia and Argentina. And it basically follows these kids and the prisoner through this high mountaintop as well as the jungle and what these kids are going through. Some of them die. Some of them get higher in rank. Some of them have love relationships. And they just basically fluctuate between these kids and this doctor of, is she going to escape from this terrorist organization? Because it's just called the organization. Or is she going to be a prisoner and get killed by these kids or teens or young adults? Or are some of these kids and young adults from the organization going to stand up and be like, I don't like what we're doing anymore, so we're going to do it. So what did I like about this movie? Like I said, from the poster, all you could see is it's a cinematic achievement of visuals. And you could say, yes, it's fantastic looking by visuals and just the stunning cinematography of the jungle, the mountains, the clouds, the sun, the water. The water is probably the most impressive part of how they show the rivers connecting and muddy water to kind of clear water and what they're doing actually in the water. It looks fantastic of that setting. Yeah, the acting of these kids were fantastic. It looked great. It was directed great. I'd say it's the story that kind of falters a little bit because it takes a while to show what's actually trying to happen. Even halfway through, you're like, what are we kind of getting at? Because it almost turns to it takes a while to get to a cat and mouse chase because you know the doctor's going to try to escape sooner or later and she's going to try to escape. What are these kids going to do? Who's going to die? And it does take a while to get there. But when it gets there, it's some shocking violence and everything. And the one kid that's actually kind of questioning his decisions, his name is Rambo in the movie. And sometimes I wanted him to Rambo the F up and just start murdering these teenagers and adults because I've never in a movie have wanted these kids, young adults, teens, whatever you want to call them, to die. I wanted these kids because what they're doing was this monstrosity. But it also one new thing is they were raised this way. They were raised by this organization, by this crime ring, by maybe the government of Colombia or the police organization. Because there's a lot of corrupt in South America. Hence Rambo, the movie. While a lot of critics hate it for the corruption, but a lot of critics love this one for corruption. Anyway. It just takes a long to get there, but when it gets there, it's very strong. Like I said, it's hard to just grasp what I did not like about this movie. Like, it's a great story. It made sense. It knew what it was doing. It's very simplistic of corruption. Who's this organization? These child soldiers who are actually real corruption in their government of, like, taking these kids. I don't even know if they know their family. From the sounds of it, these kids are taken. And they were raised to just be part of this organization. And that's all they know in their life is these 10 people, 7 people. And that's all they know. But the story is great. It ends pretty awesome. You kind of know who this organization is. Like I said, it could be the cops. Could be just a random organization of a terrorist group in the woods. It could be the government. It could just be random people. Like, you don't know. But how it ends, you're like, he knows something is about to bad happen to him. But it's one of those movies where you enjoy looking at the film, but you just wish it would get to the point sooner. And I'd say the one thing with this director, he does it on purpose. You know something bad is going to happen to some of these characters at a certain point. And he does not really a pan shot, but just a steady shot of like, something bad's about to happen to me. So he'll focus on me. And he'll focus on me for about 30, 45 seconds. He does it on purpose because what's going to happen to me could happen at the 30-second mark or the 45-second mark. And he does that multiple times in this movie of, it, like, because he gets you off guard on one of them. Like, you're like, oh, that's going to happen. Or it'll be like a 5-second one. You don't know when something bad is going to happen. I kind of like how he put that tension in the movie of, you know something bad is going to happen. Like, the audience would be dumb to not think something bad is going to happen. The director's like, you know something bad's going to happen, but you're going to have to find out when it happens. And when it does, it's going to be a struggle. You're like, ah! Because there's no music. It turns quiet. And I like movies that do that. And I was in an audience, of course, in California. There was a cow scene of basically them skinning the cow, and you could tell people are uncomfortable. But you got to think, this is another country. This is how they survive. So that's all they know about. Kind of like, would you eat your family dog? Never. But when you're hungry and that's all you have to survive, sometimes people got to do that to survive. It's one of those things where you just got to know what other countries in the world are going through. So Manos looks great, directed well, great acting by these kids, young adults, teens, I don't know their ages. Bad, a little paced, a little slow. I understand why though, but sometimes you just wish, come on, let's get going. And sometimes you're wondering how these kids got this makeup, or when they're going through these scenarios of what they're doing and who they're doing it to. Because there is like, I want to say a montage of like them destroying cars and people are coming after them, but you really don't know who's coming after them. Is it the same people that's picking up this kid at the very end, or are they really going rogue? So you want some questions to be answered and they don't answer it. So that's kind of the bummer. But Manos will receive a 3.5 out of 5 book food guns equals at 70%. So see, the critics news score gave this film. So you have critics at 92% with 105 of them, the audience score of 84% with only 31. Here's critic consensus. A visually splendid, as it is thought-provoking, Manos takes an unsettling look at human nature whose grim insights have a lingering impact. They have to agree, because you just know these kids, teens, young adults, I keep saying that because I really don't want to like label them wrong or not, because there's a weird kissing scene in the beginning. You're like, what's the point of that? I guess the point of that is to show this Rambo character. But you just know this, all the kids know. And it's kind of sad. Do you agree with the 92 though? The 84 or the 70? 92, 84, 70, was I right? Yeah. Chase Yaki the Blue Futon. Like, comment, subscribe. Well, I'm going to think it's Blue Futon Utopia, you Blue-tonians. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Like I said, tonight is going to be, I'm going to think I'm going to see the lighthouse and the Relent, the R-E-L-I-A-N-T. I was like looking through movies and I'm like, oh, what's this about? And it's like, it's a Phantom Events. You're like, oh, it's not going to be, it's almost sold out. And I'm like, it can't be sold out just here. No. It is sold out like nationwide, of like Oakland sold out. And I was like, no, let's check Texas. Most of them sold out. And I got a ticket. I'm like, you know what? Let's just see what this Phantom event is about. But like I said, Manos, if you find it, you want to watch a movie that's interesting, character study about ethical leadership as well, I would watch it.